Hello, folks. Here's a quickie little quick one for you. This time, we're just going to talk a little bit about the step mod. Okay? All right. Buckle up. This one's pretty interesting. I think you'll like it. Let's start the show. Okay, like most of Bitwig devices, what I like to do if I'm learning them is to just click a preset and choose one. Okay, let's just choose Birdie Step. I don't know. Okay, and just see what it's doing. What effect does it have? First of all, here's the sound of an A minor chord played through a stock polysynth synthesizer. Okay, and here it is with the step mod. Well, how is it achieving that exactly? Because what you'll notice if you play around with this and you're not using a preset and you don't have anything loaded in the effects is that it does nothing. But if we click the preset, or sorry, the effects here and click the mod button, and we can see that it's actually modifying a bunch of stuff in here. And so that's pretty interesting. Let's delete the stuff inside there. So basically, we can put an effect in here, and let's do that now. Let's throw a tool in there, because you're going to be able to tell volume difference obvious enough, right? Because I can't guarantee you're listening to this in stereo, so let's just choose something that's really obvious. To me, this plugin is used to mod other plugins, and to me it's like, well, wait, isn't that what all this stuff is for? Isn't that why you have this whole list here? And yeah, it is. If you want to mod a tool plugin, well, then traditionally you click this little button and you click the plus, and then you find an LFO or whatever you want to throw on there, and you use that to mod this plugin. But that's not the case for some reason with this device. With this device, you put all the devices you want inside the effects box here, and now I can click mod and I can choose what I want to mod, basically. Okay, so let's set this on something that's really obvious. Let's do something like this. Okay. And let's slow it down. Let's put it on eighth notes. Okay. And so now you can really see that I've slowed it down, what effect it's having on the volume of this track. And let me just turn down the master so that we don't kill ourselves. Right, so when it's up, this yellow dot passes a mod or a step up here, then it brings the volume down, and when it's down here, it brings the volume up, and that's just controlled by the way that I modded this. For example, see, I brought it going counterclockwise. If I bring it clockwise, now it's opposite, which means when this is when it passes a step that goes up, it brings the volume up, and then likewise is the opposite for up and down. You get the point. Okay, and now this is your speed here. Really, I know this is called speed, but this is technically how fast the yellow dot kind of runs across all of your steps, right? If you want dotted quarter notes or dotted whatever notes, in this case eighth notes, triplets, quarter notes, or just free time, and it's dictated by a frequency band, then you can choose that. This is if it repeats every time a note is played on that track, and this you can choose how many more steps you want. If I only want eight steps, well then I can bring this to back down to eight, and now these are grayed out and they're not accounted for. Speed is how fast it makes the change from one step to the next. So if I bring it up, it's an instant change. Okay, if I bring it way down, then you'll notice by looking at the amplitude that it has a little bit of a glide between all the steps, right? It's exactly like glide. So if we turn this up, it's very harsh, and if we turn it down, it's very subtle. And that's basically all there is to know about the step mod. It's a very simple device. I just think there's a lot of confusion surrounding the fact that it lives outside of this list here. And instead, it's its own device, which I thought was interesting. And then you'd have to bring whatever you want to mod, for in this instance, the tool, into the effects box there. Outside of that, it behaves basically like any mod that you would put on any device or plugin inside of Bitwig. And it's super cool. I'm thinking there's a lot that you could probably get done using this guy. Like if you want a super hyper controlled vibrato, well, you could set this up, keep the speed really low, and then you've got yourself a perfect kind of vibrato. You can put that on an amplitude or even a pitch shifter or something like that. Okay, so like I said, short and sweet, nothing crazy happening here, but I think there's a lot of creativity tools inside this, what is seemingly a simple little device, and I think you'll find the same if you get the chance to play around with it. All right, let me know what you think. Leave your comments and questions below. I love those, and thank you for subscribing if you have already, and if you haven't, feel free to. I would love that. And otherwise, have a good day. All right, kids. Talk soon.